At this point, we'll move on to studying the other main category of speech sounds, vowels. Just like with consonants, we have a very specific classification system for vowels. Unlike the consonant chart, though, the vowel chart is much less rigid. There are few squares. Instead, there are zones within which each vowel can take on a range of sounds. Overall, vowels are trickier than consonants, even though we have a solid classification system for them. One thing that makes vowels tougher is that what makes a vowel is that there's very little obstruction created in the vocal tract. Instead, articulators move in general directions without actually making contact with any of the upper surfaces. The result of this lack of obstruction is that airflow is fairly unimpeded. This also means that vowels are louder than consonant sounds in most cases. However, because the articulators don't really make contact with each other, it's much harder to feel what's happening when you make a vowel sound. And the boundaries between vowels can be quite challenging to identify. One vowel sort of bleeds into another vowel, and some vowel productions sound almost halfway in between two possible vowels. One other aspect of vowels that students often find challenging is that the symbols that the IPA uses to represent vowels are almost always different from the letters we use to spell those same vowels. In fact, many IPA vowel symbols are much more like how Spanish words are spelled, with a number of new symbols added in to represent vowels that there are no separate letters for. But before we get into the symbols, let's talk a little bit about how vowels are made. The first dimension that's discussed with vowels is called height. Vowel height refers to how high up in the mouth the highest part of the tongue is during the production of a vowel. For example, if you say e, you might be able to feel that your tongue is up high in your mouth, almost to the roof of your mouth, but not quite touching. But if you say ah, you might feel how your jaw and tongue both move down quite a bit. So we say that E is a high vowel and ah is a low vowel. Overall, most people recognize three levels of height: high, mid, and low. Some people will use some intermediate terms for some vowels, such as mid-high, to refer to a vowel that falls between the high space and the mid space. The second main dimension for vowels is frontness, or backness, or the front-back dimension. All of these mean the same thing. Again, if you say the sound e, you might be able to see that the part of the tongue that's raised up high is the front part of the tongue. But if you say the sound oo and look in your mouth, you might notice that a part of your tongue is up high, but it's the back part of your tongue, and it's raised up high in the back of your mouth. So we say that E is a front vowel and oo is a back vowel. As with the height dimension, we usually recognize three divisions within the front-back dimension: front, central, and back. Now, these two dimensions, height and backness, are often used by themselves to specify a vowel's quality. But there are some other aspects of vowels that are important to consider. We'll cover these in the next movie.